Okay? So we are invited to walk by faith and not only by sight. Okay? Now, let's start in the life of Mary. Okay, thank you so much. So, this is a retreat with Mary. She walked by faith and not by sight. Okay? Now, I would be borrowing many of the ideas from this book, Mary, A Biblical Walk with the Blessed Mother. Okay, I find it very, very good because we are invited to reflect on the readings. We don't just infer and reflect on Mary from the clouds. It must be founded on the scriptures of the Bible. So I like this. If you have the chance to come across this book, it's a beautiful thing. Okay, by Edward Sree. Okay? Now, let's start first with the four facts of Mary according to the Gospel of Luke. Four particular information about Mary. First, he is a woman from the insignificant village of Nazareth in Galilee. It's a fact that she came from Nazareth in Galilee, a certain village. Who among you have been to Holy Land? Israel, particularly. Okay, good. Have you been to Nazareth?
Yes.
I do suppose, yes. In that particular Basilica of the Annunciation?
Yeah.
Okay, that's the place of Mary. Mary received the message of the angel on that particular place where they built already a basilica. So she, you might think, firstborn son. So in other words, there will be second, third, fourth? Because they will be first. What does it mean? Okay, let's see. There are mysteries surrounding Christ's birth. The birth of Jesus is really surrounded with mysteries. And what does it mean by mystery? Somebody said, when I don't understand things, it's a mystery. A wife said, I couldn't understand my husband. He is a mystery to me. Okay? It doesn't mean that it is mysterious, you don't understand. You might understand things, but not the whole thing. But even though you don't understand, you are there. Okay? First mystery that surrounds the birth of Christ. Mary was forced by the Roman decreed census to travel to Bethlehem. Okay? So the census is an assertion of the Romans' rule over the land. Remember that at that time, the Roman Empire was the one reigning in most part of the world. It requires people to return to their ancestral hometowns. And Mary, presumably in her last trimester of her pregnancy, last 3 months, traveled with Joseph from Nazareth to Bethlehem, perhaps 4 to 5 days on. Mary was tested right away. Herod wanted to kill the child, and so Joseph and Mary fled to Egypt, exiled in Egypt. That's why in Egypt, there is this basilica or church believed to be the place where the Holy Family stayed. And then after knowing that Herod was already dead, Mary dream again, or Joseph dream again, that they have to go back. They are now free to go back to Israel. So they stayed in Egypt. But again, walking back to Israel. Remember that the first group of Israelites fled from Egypt to the Promised Land for how many years? 40 years. But actually, according to them, as far as I know, if you can walk really, it will take you 2 weeks or 3 weeks of walking from Egypt to Israel. But it took Israel to travel for 40 years. Why? Because according to, interpretation, they were indeed hard-headed. They were moving around and around, only to find out that there is a shortcut. But and they were disobedient to God. That's why there was warring moment.